Gore the dog butcher back again to cut up some dogs. Not for me to feast on, but we can have the maggots feast on these butchered dogs. But anywho, one thing I noticed, I'm not sure if it's different from where you are, if you've noticed this or not, is that when parks have no dog allowed signs, usually the sign is like very, very small. Or it's like very small. So it's you know, you look at this small sign, it's like, it's avoidable. But any other, you know, sign, usually is, you know, it stands out. But these no dog allowed signs are usually very small, very, you know, hard to read, very, you know, kind of sometimes they're maybe hidden type of things. But even with these dog no dogs allowed signs, these dog nuts still bring their dogs. They still bring their dogs to parks to contaminate the fields or the water or etc. And so these signs, they really don't do anything. These signs are counterproductive. And when these dog nuts, you know, go to a park that says no dogs allowed, they'll still bring their dog. Many won't clean up after them. Usually the police won't reinforce it. The property manager may not even reinforce it either. So these no dog allowed signs are counterproductive. And I think if we want to make a statement, we gotta make these signs a little more bigger and let them stand out. We gotta make them bigger and make them stand out. I'm looking at a no dog allowed sign. It's about maybe 30 feet away from me, and it's like washed up, very small. Like anyone could miss it. It's in a place where it's like no one would care. It's just in a spot that no one would care to look or see. And even if they do see it, it's like whatever, because the sign, it doesn't stand out. The sign is like washed up. It's very small. Any dog not looking at it would instantly think, okay, I don't have to do that. I don't have to follow this because, you know, I'm a dog nut. So I'm going to just disobey this rule. And, you know, police aren't reinforcing it. Property managements usually don't reinforce it. So it's like these dog nuts are allowed to roam free. These dog nuts are allowed to break any dog-related rule. These dog nuts are allowed to be criminals, and they're allowed to get away with it. And it's just so, you know, far-fetched. It's so counterproductive. I mean, if dogs were these, you know, great creatures, why are there signs that say no dogs allowed in parks? Like, if dogs are better than people, why are there so many though? But even though there is so many, you know these dog nuts are not going to obey it. It's not going to be reinforced. So again, these signs, they do absolutely positively nothing. They do nothing, because we all know that these dog nuts will continue to bring their dogs to any park, any place they want, regardless of the rules. And you know what they're gonna do now? They're now gonna call their dog a therapy dog or a service dog or emotional support dog. And I said this once, and I'm gonna say it again. If you're over the age of maybe 16, I'll say 16, and you have and own a service dog, then something is really, really wrong with you. You probably didn't have, you know, the smartest parents. You probably had the worst childhood. Probably you got picked on at school. No one taught you anything. So So what you think is a solution is, you know, getting the service dog to walk with you everywhere you go. But deep down, you really don't have any problems. Well, you do have a problem because you're a dog nut. But deep down, you really don't have any problems that can't be fixed on your own. Because you only, as these dog nuts will only get these dogs for pleasure, to rub it in, for, you know, to bother people, annoy people, to break the rules. So this is what the dog nut does. The dog nuts are rule breakers. They're criminals. They're bad people. They're probably demonic. They're probably possessed. They're just bad dog nuts. Dog lovers are just bad people. If any dog lover, well, if you're a dog lover, you're a bad person. Because you're a bad person, you're a disgusting person. But if you have and call your mutt a service dog, when you are very incompetent of taking care of yourself, then you are really a bad person. You are a bad seed. You're a bad weed. You're just a horrible person, really. Because again, man has survived on this planet. They've survived. They've survived without these dogs. There's been a point where no one had a pet dog. For many years, no one had a pet dog. Dogs weren't as popular. And we survived. We traveled. We survived. And we're here. And all of a sudden now, these mutt lovers, these dog lovers, these dog owners, the dog industry, the media, all of a sudden now they're endorsing and they're promoting and supporting and hiding information regarding the dogs. And that leads us back to these meaningless and useless no dog allowed signs. They're just counterproductive. They don't work. Because we know the dog nut is above the rules because they have a dog nut. Because dog nuts are just, they're special kind of people. And not special in a good way. You know, I just hate dog lovers too. I hate dog lovers. I hate dog nuts. Hate dogs. I have no patience for stupid. This is 2021, and if you're a dog nut, that means you're an idiot, and if you're an idiot, that means you're stupid. If you're stupid, it means you're dumb, and if you're dumb, then I don't like you. That's just it. That's just it. I just don't like you. If you're a dog nut, I don't like you. If you own a dog, I don't like you. You have a service dog, I don't like you. We can't negotiate with the enemy. We can't do that. If we negotiate with the enemy is gonna, you know, use that inch and take a mile out of it. And that's what's happening in this dog culture. We've gave these dog nuts an inch. And now it's going worldwide now. So dog nuts are the enemy. Dogs are the enemy. And I have no liking, no respect for the enemy. This is another worthless mutts. And remember, it's okay to hate dogs.